Hi guys, Kim Barker here. We had an incredible webinar yesterday with Dr. Susan Ashford on the power of flexing. And guess what? When the recording wasn't coming through and it wasn't coming through, I thought, what the heck? So I then realized that I had forgot to hit record and I was sick to my stomach. And the song from Cher, "If I Could Turn Back Time," kept going through my mind over and over again. I don't think I will ever forget to hit record again. However, I decided to shift to a growth mindset. And I thought, okay, what could I do? I could summarize this webinar a little bit. I won't do it justice, but because Dr. Ashford is one of my heroes, I just couldn't ask her to do it again. So I want to tell you a little bit about Dr. Ashford. She is the Michael and Susan Jander Noah Professor and is the former chair of management and organizations at the Ross School of Business at the University of Michigan. She has received 2 Lifetime Achievement Awards from the Academy of Management. Her research has been published in the Academy of Management Review, the Academy of Management Journal, Administrative Science Quarterly, Strategic Management Journal, the Journal for Applied Psychology, Harvard Business Review, and many others. She is an incredible scholar. Adam Grant, who we all know, right? And we love his 2 TED Talks, said that this book fundamentally changed how he thinks about being proactive and adaptable now. Dr. Ashford's book could do the same for you. It's filled with lucid, practical insights about how to get better feedback, learn more rapidly, and speak up more effectively. In times of turbulence, her expert advice is the anchor we all need, and I could not agree more. Dr. Ashford talks about being the person your dog thinks you are, which I just love because don't our dogs think the sun rises and sets on us? It's really about taking these small daily experiments to create life-changing growth and big wins. It's about how to get outside of your comfort zone. And in the book, she shares 6 steps in order to be able to do that. There's a quote in the book, you know me, you guys know how much I love quotes, right? By John Maxwell, "Change is inevitable, growth is optional. A life well lived tends to keep us off center. Just when we think we have all the answers and have organized our lives perfectly, something happens to unsettle our thinking and spoil our plans." And this book tells us how to deal with those situations and turn them from negatives into positives. She used an example, and I love this example because I have been in this example. Let's say the morning after holiday weekend, you have an evaluative situation at work. What do you do? Do you stress all weekend over it? Do you fret all weekend? Or are you mindful? Do you manifest and use the law of attraction to think through, to plan properly, to write down questions, and to trust that it'll go great? That is what it's all about. And she talks about how to flex for cross-cultural engagement. And you know, I love cross-cultural engagement, anything related to culture. And one thing she said you can do is use short-term simulations, right? You can develop specific skills through role-playing, trial and error exercises, action learning, in which team members practice techniques for situation analysis and volunteerism, right? When you volunteer, you develop a global mindset and an appreciation for diversity. I just love that. She talks about how this flexing mindset can help you in organizations. True learning organizations find systematic ways to reinforce through words and actions that skills are learnable rather than assuming they are innate talents or gifts that some people have and others lack. Have a top management that conveys consistency, that the organization values and rewards learning and perseverance, not just ready-made genius and talent, and establish policies and procedures that support these attitudes. Create feedback systems that promote a focus on learning in the future, and treat managers as resources for learning rather than taskmasters whose role is to impose discipline and expose wrongdoing. There's so many incredible stories here. And I just want to encourage you to get the book today and check it out. There were some really good questions that were asked. One suggestion the book has is to journal and record events of the day and your intellectual and emotional responses to them. Find 10 minutes every day to do this. It can really help you reflect. And we talked about why people don't reflect. Sometimes it's scary to reflect, right? But you're not going to grow if you don't do that. It's also scary to get feedback. But it's important that you get feedback. And it's important that you get feedback from those you trust. Dr. Ashford talked about savoring and how when something goes really well, you just savor it, right? You're in the moment, you savor it, and you enjoy it that much longer, which I thought was so wonderful. She also talked about a lifeline exercise that she's done in many of her classes. And that is that you create a 90-degree angle, okay? So on the bottom is life, vertically is growth, and then you go and you plot emotional highs and lows throughout your life, situations that have shaped you. And when you look at it and you look at those lows, which are represented by dots, isn't it true that you've learned so much more from those lows than from highs? I mean, I keep trying to build character by eating chocolate cake and it just doesn't work. Usually it's the tough stuff that you learn from. And in this book, Dr. Susan Ashford talks about learning to use the tough stuff to create win-win situations. So I just want to share with you really quickly the little PowerPoint I made, and I want to encourage you to get this book today. You will be so happy you did. So many people texted me after the webinar. They called me. I can't wait to read this book. It was so good. So please, please take a look at getting it today. And I also want to give you a reminder. Our next webinar is on May 9th with Jervis Bush on generative leadership. I promise I won't forget to hit record. The Eastern Michigan University Professional College of Business Professional Development Summer 2023 book read, our first of three discussions on this book, Designing Your Life, How to Build a Well-Lived, Joyful Life, is on July 12th. Please go ahead and check that out. I will send these out. Also, take a look at some of these resources. ISODC, International Society for Organization Development and Change.org. Is a wonderful group and with many scholars and practitioners. They have a great LinkedIn group. We also have our Culture Change and Leadership LinkedIn group, my YouTube page at Kimberly Barker, PhD, I think, it's right there, has many, many good talks like this one. And so please hit subscribe and ring the bell. And we have many playlists that are just great. There are so many of the videos I use in my classes, including there's some videos by Susan Dweck. She has a Google talk on creating a growth mindset, which is an excellent video. I invite you to take a look and check those out. And my book, You Can Create Positive Change at Work, with my co-author, Mary Checkinese, is now available on Kindle and Amazon in paperback and in Google Books. So go ahead and as well as on the website there. So go ahead and check that out. And let's make a positive difference in our world by flexing ourselves, stepping outside our comfort zone, and we can create positive change. Okay. Thanks so much.